So a huge update with this tank is that I exchanged the frag rack for some live rock. If you're new to this channel, I set this tank up about a year and a half ago as a propagation tank, which is why it's shallow. It's 5 feet by 3 feet by 16 inches high. It served its purpose well, but I got tired of looking at the egg crate. And since I added the dedicated frag tank to the 120, I was able to remove the frags out of this system. At first, I had this unrealistic vision of turning this into a nice lagoon-style tank with a couple of islands, but that's not gonna happen because that looks best with sand, which I don't have. And I still need this tank as a grow-out tank, so I need to use the entire footprint for corals. I did put some effort in the aquascape though. I actually tried to make it look like a single island from afar while still giving the fish room to swim, and have it open enough so it wouldn't be hard to siphon out the detritus during a water change. The scape is all Fiji rock that I hoarded when it was still available a couple years ago. I cut all the original pieces with my diamond bandsaw to make them skinnier and less boulder-like, and I bonded them together with E-Marco cement, a little bit of epoxy here and there, and some fiberglass rods. After I had the structures built, I soaked them in a muriatic acid solution and gave them a good scrub. As with my 120, I pre-drilled holes in the rocks for my removable frag mounts, which I can't live without. I made a separate video on that process a while ago if you're new to the channel and you want to check it out. I'll leave a link for it in the description below along with some other helpful links. So I cut off all the colonies from the tiles and glued them to my custom peg mounts. I did keep some of the tiles that had a lot of encrusting coral on them. I still have some work to do as far as moving the corals around to balance the colors, and the back corner I need to make the aquascape a little higher and fill in some big gaps back there, but overall I'm happy with how it turned out. Being artistic with my aquascape is definitely not a strength of mine, so I usually rely on filling the tank with corals to make the aquarium look decent. For flow, I have 4 Tunzi 6105s, 2 of them are running on either side of the island and the other 2 are on sea sweeps blowing across the tops of the corals. For lighting, I have 2 250 watt metal halides with a 24 inch reef breeder's fixture between them and some DIY LED fixtures on the sides. This particular fixture I added recently to give me more coverage. As far as filtration, I run this tank similar to my 120 gallon. I use a Vertex Alpha 200 for my skimmer, Roafos in a Fosban reactor, Bucket Refugium, and I dose calcium, alkalinity, and magnesium. The sump is disgusting because I took out the filter sock. I usually run one, but I took it out because I'm having cyano problems. What was happening was the cyano was getting caught in the socks and living happily on them. Now with the sock out, they have a better chance of being removed by the skimmer, which I actually adjusted to skim wetter during this time. Also to combat the cyano, I stopped dosing AcroPower, and I scrubbed the cyano off the rocks and glass every couple of days. These measures seem to be helping and the cyano is slowly going away. But really, it's no surprise that the tank had an outbreak of something, since I disrupted the biology by switching the frag rack out for uncycled dry rock. Thankfully, I had zero coral or fish losses during this time. Also, what I did to help ease the transition was not clean the glass for a month before the switch, and I didn't clean it until after I saw coralline growing on the rocks. Growth on the glass is technically biological filtration, and I view it as the tank striving to reach an equilibrium. That's also something that I do when something seems off. I'll leave the glass untouched, and I'll do water changes to get me out of trouble. Well, that's going to be it for this update, guys. Nothing left to do except show more coral shots. Let me know if you have any questions, and thanks for watching.